Hello and welcome class 12 students. Today in this class I will explain to you the different factors of motivation. This is the third class of motivation, and in this class I will focus in today's class about the factors or aids to motivation. The employees can be motivated by acknowledging their social needs and recognizing their importance in the organization. Management tries to motivate the employees with the hope of getting better result from them. The following factors generally aid to motivate the employees. What are the factors? Let's see one by one. The first factor is, of course, the monetary incentives. Money is above all, right? So, monetary incentives. Nobody works for a social cause. Nobody works in the organization for a social cause. So, money is the most important motivator. Money determines the standard of living of a people and gives him self-confidence. Money incentives involve direct and indirect rewards, measurable in terms of money. Monetary incentives include wages, salaries, allowances, profit, bonus, and also leave with pay, then medical treatment. Many types of monetary incentives can be given. Money can be given in different forms, in forms of awards and sharing and allowances and medical reimbursement and even some cash rewards or some bonus or some pensions. So money can come in different forms. So money is the best reward that can act as a motivating factor. So the main motivation comes from the monetary incentives. That's why I have kept this point as in the first priority of this answer, that is monetary incentives, because money is above all. Every employee gets motivated because of this money first. Money is the first priority. Other social behavior and other points are also there which act as a important motivator, but money is above all. So this leads to a great, it creates a great psychological force from within to work, to keep someone committed towards the organization if he is monetarily happy, if monetary incentive is sound in the organization. Next is recognition. Definitely another important, not only monetary factor, but recognition plays a lot. Maybe sometimes some people doesn't work for money. Some people works for proper recognition in the organization, recognition for good work, acknowledgement and appreciation of good performance. If recognition of such kind is derived from the organization, then somebody will, why he will not able be working. All the time, money is definitely the main factor, but all the time money is not the main factor. Sometimes recognition of good work, sometimes appreciation, these also work as an important factor in case of motivation. Sometimes some word of praise, a letter of appreciation, a recognition is given for a better output, saving in time, improving the quality of production. All these are kind of different kind of recognition. Now, recognition inspire employees to improve the performance by putting their best effort. So, all the time money is not the main factor. Sometimes recognition also plays a different and a difficult and an important role. So, next is social status. Social status. Now, what does this mean? Social status means formal position of the employee in the organization. Social status motivates the employee by satisfying their egoistic needs. It may create some status symbols in the organization. This can be done by way of giving various facilities to the employees. When an employee achieves certain facilities, then he tries to get better status by working more. In this way, status needs act as a motivator. Many a times we have seen some people working in the organization because they are getting their ego satisfied. Their ego is being properly satisfied in the organization, and for that reason their status enhanced increases, and for this increase in the status, they tend to feel committed towards the organization, feel more responsible towards their work. So this also, the social status also matters a lot for them, and not the monetary factor always act as a motivator for some kind of people in the organization. So this is also one important point. Next is stability. Definitely for some people, stability matters a lot. Stability matters a lot for some people. Stability in the organization. Security of job is considered to be most essential for some people. Some people may not feel that money is the best factor. Some people may feel that stability is the main motivator. If I'm stable in my job, if I'm satisfied with my job, why will I change my job so frequently? If I'm stable in it, if I'm very much satisfied with my work, why will I feel to change my work? So even if somebody offers a better salary, a better remuneration for a change of job, somebody would like to stick to his job because of the stability, because of the continuity he has been doing, the commitment, the way he's serving. He's very much satisfied with the atmosphere and satisfaction, job satisfaction, security matters, stability matters. Maybe he can get tempted with the good job offer, good remuneration, but there may not be the atmosphere is so much stable like the present atmosphere where somebody is working. So atmosphere and stability matters a lot. Security matters a lot. So sometimes stability or security of the job boost up the morale of the employees, and the employees should follow such a labor policy that will ensure security to the job, which is essential to those employees who does not look for monetary incentive, who are general type, who have little chance to leave the job and go elsewhere. So people will try not to go elsewhere and stay in their job if they feel satisfied with their job. So this is one important factor, stability. Next is opportunity for promotion. So another important factor is this promotion. There should be opportunity, or there should be a scope of promotion. Employees want not only security of the job, but also good opportunity for promotion every year. Employees should be made to realize that the organization provides ample opportunities for promotion to those who deserves it on their merit basis. This feeling will boost up their morale, and they will perform their duties with great zeal and vigor if there is a scope, good scope for promotion on the merit basis. So this is another important. Next is participation in the management. The participation of the employees in the decision making process creates a sense of belonging to the organization. Participation satisfies the ego and self-esteem needs of the employees. Participation helps employees to develop positive attitude towards their work and the organization. Therefore, participation has been considered as a good technique for motivation. Next is post-retirement benefit. The seventh point is post-retirement benefit. Post-retirement benefit. The employees generally show more interest in their present work with the hope of getting future benefits. Post-retirement benefits are pension, gratuity, provident fund. All these type of post-retirement benefits are associated with the jobs of the employee working in the organization. They act as a motivator to show more eagerness towards their present work. If the employees get to know that they are getting good benefits after the retirement, then they will show more eagerness in their present work status. So post-retirement benefit also matters a lot. So these are the factors of motivation. These are the aids to motivate an employee. I hope whatever I have explained, you have understood. In my next class, I will come up with some more things about this motivation. Till then, goodbye.